Good evening, Davao, Mindanao. We are here at Sky Cable Channel 15 for a new program, no? Similar face, same face, but iba ng programa ito, no? This all about politics, especially so that the campaign period is fast approaching. So I thought it was proper to have a new program on about election 2010. So friends, televiewers, the title of the show is Election 2010, and this is primarily, of course, to pursue the agenda of the official candidate of the Liberal Party, Senator Noynoy Aquino, and of course, for President and for Vice President Marujas. So tonight, we are lucky to have a guest that's no less than the Director General of the Liberal Party to talk about these two candidates that we have, Senator Aquino and Senator Marujas. Good evening, Chito. This is Chito Gascon, by the way, no? Chito, magandang gabi, and we have the pleasure to introduce yourself and give your preliminary statements.
Yes, magandang gabi, Ed, at sa lahat ng mga nakikinig dito sa Davao at sa Mindanao. It's a pleasure to be here in the initial episode of Election 2010, and we want to congratulate you and all of those who are behind this production so that the public may know about the issues surrounding this election, which, by the way, is just 150 days from this time.
Yung campaign period.
The campaign period will officially begin for national office on February 9, 90 days before the elections, and for local, it will be March 24, about 45 days before elections on May 10, 2010. So this program is certainly an opportune time for the public in Mindanao, particularly in the Davao provinces, to be aware about the issues surrounding this election. So
yes,
thank you very much for this opportunity.
Yes, Chito, tama ngayon na kasi most often, ang naririnig natin, people in the national level talking about these two candidates o sila mismo nag-usap. But this venue, this show, is para magkakaroon ng venue yung taga-Davao, taga-Davao region and Mindanao to talk about Liberal Party, to talk about the agenda of Noynoy and Mar, and magkakaroon ng better appreciation, no? Kung bakit talaga natin gusto itong mga tao nito. Meron tayong initial, of course, initial desire, bakit o criteria, bakit gusto natin sila. And that is, of course, yung tinatawag na good governance na paniwala natin na these two guys will carry on after 2010 elections. So, siguro, for my first question sa iyo, Chito, would be, how is these two candidates now? Kumusta sila? Nasaan sila ngayon? What are they doing? And with reference to the Liberal Party, kasi katatapos na nung filing, no? So ibig sabihin, we have set of candidates na makapag-file na. Hindi naman candidates ang tawag doon, na intent, no? File intention to become a candidate, technically, no? So how is our Marujas and Noynoy Aquino and all the other Liberal Party lineup?
Yes. Well, first, how they are? Well, they're certainly very busy. It's been a very busy 2 months for all of us, you know, since September 1, when Mar decided to step aside in favor of Noynoy, and then September 9, the 40th day after the death of Cory Aquino, Noynoy took up the challenge. And from that point, actually, it's been very, very busy for both Noynoy and Mar. But this particular week is also particularly difficult for both of them, because while they are also trying to respond to the demands of the people to go out and meet them, they also have senatorial duties, as you know, over the weekend.
Duty
President, of course, President Arroyo declared martial law in Maguindanao. And the constitution mandates that within 48 hours, a report should be issued, and that report was issued last Sunday. And then the Senate and the House are now in deliberations as to how they will conduct the joint session to determine the sufficiency of the basis for the declaration of martial law. I myself, having been a member of the body which wrote the constitution, was consulted by our leaders, and I did say that on its face it appears that there was insufficiency of any basis, because the constitution in Article 7 says martial law may only be declared in two instances. One is invasion and the other is rebellion. Of course, they are arguing, those who are justifying martial law, that there was an actual rebellion that occurred in Maguindanao by the mere fact of finding large cache of arms that happened to be arms of the
military
of the AFP. You had it in the boxes, Department of National Defense.
It was manufactured recently. June 2009 yung manufacturing date.
Exactly. So, but you know, rebellion is when people rise up and bear arms against government. In this case, they
arms of the government.
They were not rising.